What's going on, guys, and welcome back to Forza Motorsport 6. Today I'm going to be starting off the Forza Motorsport 6 World Championship. Basically, I'm going to get a bunch of countries together and they're going to go up against each other to see which one can go fastest in a bunch of different rounds. We're starting off today with round 1, which is B-Class front-wheel drive cars. So, we've got 6 countries in this event. We're going to start off today with the United Kingdom. I went for the Mini John Cooper Works GP. This is a pretty decent car. And after upgrading it to the top of B-Class, it now has 278 horsepower, weighs 2,491 pounds. It is, I believe, the lightest car. I'm just looking through my list here. Yes, it is the lightest car out of all of them. However, it is also the least powerful. So, the Mini went pretty well. It was fairly nice to drive. I decided to go on the Top Gear test track because I thought I wanted to use a track that I knew quite well, especially to start off with. So I went for the Top Gear test track. The Mini was pretty good. It felt quite average. It was, it was an alright time. I'm not going to tell you the time right now. We will get to that at the end so we can see all the times together. But altogether, I think the Mini John Cooper Works GP did pretty well. I'm glad that I picked this car. It was pretty decent. The next country would be the USA, United States of America. I went for the Ford Focus ST. I believe this is the 2013 model. I didn't actually put the year down here, but I believe it was something like 2013. And this was a very nice car. I do like the Ford Focuses. They're one of my favorite kind of hot hatch cars, the Ford Focus. I'm more of a fan of the older model than the one you're seeing right now. However, this one is growing on me a little bit. I mean, I really like the Ford Focus RS. I think that's just an absolutely amazing looking car. The ST is okay. However, I definitely prefer an RS over an ST. Who wouldn't, to be honest? The older generation of Focus I would still prefer over this one. However, it's a very nice car. It drives very nicely, as you would expect from, a Ford Focus. It's got 324 horsepower and 2,917 pounds of weight, which kind of puts it around the middle towards the higher end of the spectrum. Next up, we've got Japan, and I went for the Mazda Speed 3. I've never actually driven this car in any game ever because, let's be honest, it's not the most interesting car, is it? It's a little bit of a boring car. However, when I upgraded this car, it actually turned out being the most powerful car out of all 6, with 369 horsepower, weighing 3,182 pounds. It does mean that it is the heaviest car here, the only car over 3,100 pounds. Actually, I think this is the most powerful and the heaviest. The Focus is second most powerful and the second heaviest. So, the power was pretty good. However, you could tell with this car the weight was slowing it down a little bit. It understeered around quite a few corners, especially with obviously front-wheel drive. All these cars are front-wheel drive. But with that little bit of weight as well, the understeer was just a little bit worse. It wasn't the nicest thing to drive. However, when you got on the straight, it was pretty damn quick. Next up we have Italy, and for this I chose the Alfa Romeo Giulietta Quadrifoglio Verde, or whatever the hell, however you pronounce that. I just put down the Giulietta QV because, frankly, Quadrifoglio whatever the hell would not fit on my page. So let's just call it the Alfa Romeo QV or something like that. It's a very nice car. I mean, I really do quite like this car. Alfa Romeos are absolutely stunning looking cars. This one is the same, really, as any other Alfa Romeo. And you know what? It drove pretty well as well. It was a really quite a nice car to drive. This car had 319 horsepower and weighed 2,815 pounds. So, I think it's the third most powerful car out of all these. But it isn't the third heaviest. I believe it's the fourth heaviest. So, this was a very nice car to drive. Probably one of my favourite, if not my favourite car, my favourite handling car, because it did handle very, very well. Next up, we've got Germany, and I went for the Volkswagen Scirocco R. The Scirocco R is a car that I do quite like. I've driven it quite a lot in a few different games. Mainly just Gran Turismo 6, to be honest. I did a race car build on it, and it's a pretty nice car. I do prefer the Volkswagen Golf over the Scirocco personally. However, all the newer Golfs anyway in this game are four-wheel drive. So I think there was an older generation Golf that was front-wheel drive, but I thought, all the other cars in the series are on this round, should I say, are a lot newer, so I thought I should probably go with the Scirocco to make it a little bit fairer in that aspect. It was very nice to drive, ended up having 296 horsepower, which actually makes it the second to least powerful car, and weighs 2,894 pounds. So it's the third heaviest as well. So yeah, but the Scirocco actually pretty nice. It drove well, and I was all around pretty happy with it. And finally, we have France, and I chose the Renault Clio RS 200. Now, I was wondering whether to put France in this series or not, because the problem is, France has a lot of cars, but it doesn't have any manufacturers. The only manufacturers, or French manufacturers, in the game are Renault, Peugeot, and Bugatti, as far as I know anyway. And that's not really gonna cut it, so maybe... it may end up coming out of the series, it may be replaced with something else, there may be some other countries, you know, coming in and out as the series go, but for now, France is here. The Renault Clio has 298 horsepower, so just 2 more horsepower than the Scirocco, weighs 2,633 pounds. So it's a pretty light car, it's a relatively decent power car, and it was actually really nice to drive. It really, really got around the track nice, it got around the corners like crazy, it was just a really, really good car. So here we are with the final times. We have the Renault Clio RS in first place with a 121.812, the Scirocco R in second with a 121.828, then we've got the Ford Focus ST with a 122.301, then we have the Alfa Romeo with a 122.362, then followed by the Mini with a 122.562, and finally in last place the Mazda Speed 3 with a 122.702. That means that the current standings for this championship are France are in first, Germany are in second, we've got USA in third, Italy 4th, UK 5th, and Japan 6th. I don't know how the scoring is working yet because I haven't sorted it out, but that will probably be on the screen as well. If not, it will be up for next time. Anyway, that is going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed, please go ahead, like, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.